Hey, everybody. Welcome. Deborah King Live. So jazzed to be with you. Let's get started.
I'm sitting on top of the world. Just rolling along. Yes, rolling along. I'm quitting the blues of the world. I'm singing a song. Yes, singing a song. I just phoned the parson and said, "Pa, get ready to fall." Just like Humpty Dumpty, I'm gonna fall. I'm sitting on top of the world. I'm rolling along, yeah, rolling along.
Up here, and hope you are having a good time already. And you know, you can call my little red phone today. I promise it's working. You know, we're out of Mercury retrograde, and I guarantee you'll be able to reach me today. That number is 1-888-1-888-DEB-SHOW, or if you're international, it is, can't remember. So they'll throw it on the screen here pretty bit in just a minute. So today I'm going to say a few words about three keys I want to give you to manifest the future that you should be walking into right now. Your future, it's up there in your eighth chakra above your head, and here's a chance to learn how to download that thing right into your body and your personality, right? So that's what I'll be talking about shortly. And there'll be a meditation involved, so it'll be really fun. But first, I want to talk about the solstice, because the solstice is today. Happy solstice, everyone. Love the solstice. Absolutely. June 21st is my favorite time of year. You know, the whole thing is most famous in Stonehenge. Maybe you've been there. It's been years since I've been there. It's in the UK. They're not sure what those, all of that is, you know, who built it or how long ago, thousands of years ago. The most recent astrological findings suggest it was a place of healing. Now, I like that because that's the business I'm in, healing. So I think it's very possible. I was very moved when I was there. And I want to wish you a really special solstice. And I want to encourage you to get outside. Get outside with Mother Nature. You know, go swimming, take a walk, go to the woods, go to the beach. You know, really, isn't this the time from now until at least where I live, till the end of October, you know, middle of November. So I really want to encourage you to do that. And, just enjoy the flowers. Look at all the flowers we have around us today. So let me take a second and introduce the band. We've got our guy Jack Lee here, our music director over here on keyboard and a bunch of other instruments. And right behind him is JB. Go JB. He's one of our mainstays. And Dahlia is right behind JB. And she's one of our newer members, got a beautiful soprano voice. What a treat it is to have Dahlia. And then way down behind her is our guy, James. Yay, James, on drums and vocals. And next to him is Lee. Lee's our man on violin. And bring Lee up. our man on violin and guitar, very talentedly. Love having you. And over here on this side, I've got my friend Lois, who's, you know, holds the whole thing together. Okay, just an incredible voice. And right behind her, Natalie. Love Natalie, who's just been gracing us and got a real good song she's going to sing for you today. And then our guy David. Hey, David, on the sax and a couple other instruments. All right. Let's do another song, you guys.
One, two.
Oh, let me just say one thing about it. I want to remind you, this is an old Opry song, Grand Old Opry. A lot of you will know this one. And, you know, it's country music's most iconic. I have quite a love of country music. We haven't done much country music, but we will this year. So join with us in singing this one, okay?
One, two, three, four.
There are loved ones in the glory whose dear friends you often miss. When you close your earthly story, will you join them in their bliss?
Will the circle be unbroken by and by? By and by, is a better home awaiting in the sky, in the sky.
One by one,
you guys all put together. So again, I want to talk about three keys to really move you into your future. Let's go do that now.
Thank you.
So I'd like to share with you these three main ingredients that I was just mentioning that that Source requires of you before it will, you know, unleash the power for you, really. I'll tell you how it works. So the first ingredient is forgiveness, oddly enough, okay? And you have to forgive first yourself and then those who've harmed you in some way. Holding on to unforgiveness really holds us back. So the reason forgiveness is required is because as long as we hold a grudge or mad at ourselves for a mistake we've made, we're diverting critical energy that we need to move up. We're being counterproductive. We're pursuing the wrong thing. And unforgiveness from a vibrational standpoint, from an energy medicine standpoint, takes our whole vibration down and pollutes our body and mind. And we sit there in a pile of shame and blame, right? So unforgiveness is similar to drinking poison with the expectation that somebody else is going to die. So maybe forgiveness seems like a bridge too far for you, but if you can remind yourself that every time you signed on to this lifetime with these experiences that you're bringing yourself, this is all, we're doing this all out of choice. And whatever we're not forgiving has been brought to us by other teachers in our life. Think of everyone in your life and all the problems they cause. They're the teachers, right? And they incarnated to teach you that lesson, among other things, and to learn lessons of their own. So these people that we think of as adversaries, they are not. They are beacons. So we have to really reorient our thinking here, don't we? They are saying, hello, here's where you're stuck. And if you can get beyond this and free up your energy, open your energy field, you can pursue what you really want instead of staying stuck. Because, you know, we regret something we did or something that somebody did to us, and we're stuck. We aren't going to move. And when we forgive ourselves or others or both, we are acknowledging, you know, what they call the blessing in the lesson, right? And the fact that now we're wiser, we learned something, we're more resilient than we otherwise would have been had this lesson not occurred. Okay, that's number one, forgiveness. Number two is fearlessness. And you know that when we're infants, we're born with only two inborn fears. Only two are innate. I don't know if you know what they are. It's the fear of falling and the fear of loud noises. Isn't that fascinating? I think that's so interesting. I was just noticing that's all my puppy's afraid of is falling. She looks at steps really carefully and thinks, is that too far down? And she hates loud noise. So all other fears we learned them as the result of somebody indoctrinating fear into us, usually our caregiver, or our own experiences, right, which cause fear. Most of the time, indoctrination is the culprit. So most fear is an illusion. You know, there's an acronym for fear. It's false evidence that appears real. False evidence appearing real. So I love to quote people, and Albert Einstein has a great quote here. He says, I think the most important question facing us humans is the universe a friendly place or not? He's brilliant, right? So he went on to say, if we decide that the universe is unfriendly, we're going to use our technology, our science, and all our natural resources to build bigger walls around ourselves, to keep out what we perceive as the other, usually people, right? The other, different color, different language or whatever. Unfriendly, we think they're unfriendly. And we're going to build bigger weapons to destroy anything that we perceive of as unfriendly. But if we decide, on the other hand, that the universe is a friendly place, then we use our technology, our science, and our natural resources to create tools that help us move forward. So power and safety come through this understanding. So Einstein, he ended by saying, I want to underscore this, his last thought in this realm was, God does not play dice with the universe. Think about that for a minute. God does not play dice with the universe. Well, I agree with Albert Einstein. I consider the universe a very friendly place because I know that Source is unconditionally friendly. I've, on occasion, been able to connect to it and stay in it long enough to realize it's unconditional love. And it allows everything that is here to remain here, to be here. So Source loves all of us and all of it, everything that, you know, that's around us. And love can only love. It doesn't have any other choice. It's cool, huh? And love produces its own essence. So we can learn from that, right? That's our lesson. We're here to find unique personal ways. Each one of us are different. A unique personal way to manifest this unconditional love. Maybe by the work you do, the people you influence, you know, in your sphere, in your circle. Whatever skills and talents that you have or you are developing, because of course the more open you are and the more you progress in the direction I'm pointing, the more skills come to you. We enrich the lives of our loved ones. That's everything. That's animal, vegetable, mineral, and human, right? The planet and the universe. So again, that's why it's so counterproductive to be lugging fear around. So you don't want to lug unforgiveness around or fear around. So stay afraid of loud noises and falling. Those are good ideas, okay? It's built into your DNA. But try to rid yourself of all other fears, because fear, again, like unforgiveness, it's taking your critical energy that you need to expand and have a higher vibration. It leaves you stuck with unhelpful imaginings that you create in your mind. Oh, what if, and that's going to happen. And, you know, it keeps us from boldly achieving the results we want in our life. So embrace your life, embrace every new lesson, however painful, and your goals will be fearlessly attained. Okay, there's a third ingredient. Remember, I said there's three. So there's forgiveness and fearlessness. And the third ingredient I like to call future telling, so I can use alliteration, right? Use the F sound. And you could also call it vivid visioning. What's it? It's the universe wants to see your blueprint, not somebody else's. So Source has to see your blueprint to deliver you exactly what you need to help you reach your goals and the future that you're trying to download and make real in this body, in this lifetime. So the most common question I get as a spiritual teacher is, Deborah, I'm not sure what I want. What should I want? And this is really a difficult question for me, because what it tells me is that you aren't doing any vivid visioning. When you can't see what you want vividly, Source hasn't received an order from you to fill. It's that simple. So you have to figure out what you want. That's step one. And then you have to be really specific. Let me use an example. For example, suppose you need a car. I mean, honest to God, you need a car. And if you vividly imagine it, the make, the year, the color of the seats, the accessories, don't forget you want a working engine and everything else in working order. You can't leave critical stuff out. Now, if you don't care what make or model, you could ask for a car that runs well, although it's more fun to pick, you know, the baby blue car of your dreams. But you got to let the universe know that you're not just looking for a vehicle, because they might deliver by accident, you know, a tractor or a boat or an airplane. That would be kind of fun, right? But so you can't just say a vehicle. You need to actually picture, because Source requires specifics. It's the darndest thing. Source wants to deliver your vision. It's a combination of your higher, what is Source? It's a combination of you, your higher self up there in your eight and higher chakras, and everything beyond the expanded universe, because we're part of Source. We are part of Source. So this whole energy field needs to see your vision as clearly as you do. Now, if Source delivers something that you didn't ask for, maybe that's the vehicle that's going to get you where you're trying to go right now. You might trust the answer. Source knows the best vehicle to help you attain your goal. Maybe it's not the job you wanted or the car you wanted, or, you know, you understand. The source sometimes is ahead of you. Now, here's one other thing you want to think about. Source will never go get you something you're perfectly capable of getting for yourself. I want you to think about that for a minute. You can't just put in an order and then sit there waiting for this giant vending machine in the sky to, you know, drop it in your lap. You do have to take some action. You've been given energy, immense energy, really, and skills and latitude to manifest whatever it is that you want or need. As long as your goal is a beneficent one, it's prompted by goodwill and a desire to benefit all, you know, in your circle or your family or whatever the, you know, the item is, Source will be willing to respond, sometimes in really miraculous ways. Have you noticed? So do everything you can do by yourself to reach your goal, but keep vividly visioning it and leave the rest to Source. Remember always, though, to ask for additional help from the spirit guides. The spirit world, they're not gate crashers. You have to invite them. You have to literally invite them. Now, we're going to do a guided meditation in a minute to help you integrate these three keys. But before we do, let's go sing another song. Into this next song, I want to share with you that we have a special surprise for you right toward the tail end of the show today. So be sure you don't go away. You're going to be blown away by our special deal. Okay. What's our next song?
One, two, three, two, three.
Close my eyes and dance.
a beautiful rendition of that song. That's one of Bonnie Logan's songs. Bonnie is just this really amazing singer-songwriter who's been so generous to offer us her songs for you. So that's another one. We did one a month or so ago of Bonnie's, and if you go to her site, you can play it again, or you can play it here on Facebook or YouTube. You know, our shows continue. They're always available to you to replay. All right, let's go back and do that meditation I was talking about. So just to recap, right, we talked about three things, the three keys that show the universe how serious you are about achieving what it is you're trying to achieve. And it can be anything you want, anything. You know, a relationship, health. I mean, it can be absolutely anything. Remember, it's forgiveness, fearlessness, and fortune-telling or vivid visioning. So let's go right now on a guided meditation with me together. We'll get some instruments behind me. I want to help you envision this. And you can do it later, you know, at your leisure. You can do it again. So just close your eyes. If you're driving, don't close your eyes. Close your eyes. Get comfortable. Let's all just take a big, deep breath. Take another deep breath. So now you probably feel pretty relaxed and alert. And I want you to picture in front of you a stairway. And you're going to go up the stairs with me. First, we go to the first step, and then the second, and the third, and the fourth, and fifth, and sixth, and seventh. 8th, 9th, and then join me up here on the 10th floor. Just a beautiful place. And then up here at the top, we see three doors. And the one on your left has the number 1 on it. And one straight in front of you has a 3. And the one over to the right has a 5 on it. So 1, 3, 5. Now, which door are you going to go through? This will depend on whether you think your goal will take you 1, 3, or 5 months, or 1, 3, or 5 years. It depends, right? So you pick a door that corresponds to your estimated time frame, and just walk through it with me. And as we walk through, notice there's kind of a cloudy mist that obscures our vision of what lies beyond. But just intend for it to become less misty, less dense. And we'll walk further, just on a path. And now you can see what lies ahead. It's pretty clear. So in this meditation, you are walking into your future. Every detail of it is right in front of you. Right in front of you. What's it look like? Where are you? What are you wearing? What are you doing? And you're already blessing everyone, right, that you see around you. There's other people supporting your vision. And then there's people way out beyond your view, and you send blessings to them too. And then to make it more concrete, ask, where are you in the world? And are there any animals around? What are the sounds, the sights, the scent? Take in everything you can about this place and this time and this moment. And then later, after we close today, take a moment and write it down. Write down what you see here. You can do it on your laptop or your iPad or good old-fashioned pencil and paper. But right now, just stay in the ambiance of where you are at the moment. I want you to feel a sense of accomplishment that you have met your goal. Just embrace it. This is your future. It is now. It is now. You know, and if tears are coming to you, that means this vision is real, right? If you feel strongly about it, that means that you've embraced forgiveness, you've vanquished fear, you've gotten rid of it. Pictured your vision so strongly and so accurately that Source is bringing it to you right now, right this minute. Just allow this to deepen in you. Let it profoundly deepen so it's a crystal clear manifestation of your future. You know, you might feel goosebumps or you might be, you know, smiling. Whatever emotion you feel at the moment, you'll feel that same emotion when you reach that goal in real time. If anything unpleasant comes up, like a fear, join with me right now as we ask all the guides and Source to help us overcome whatever emotion is holding us back, getting in our way. We want to experience full-throated joy, don't we? As we gaze on our future, and that unpleasant emotion or thought you might have, that's just a voice in your head, right? So just disregard it. It's not the real you. It's not the real future. You are unbelievably powerful. You are completely capable of achieving this goal. You came into this lifetime to achieve this goal. Honestly, you did. This is why you're here. Remember, the universe is a very friendly place. Anything that isn't love and fearlessness is just an illusion. Fear and doubt are simply illusions. They're not real. Okay, take one more look around and then head back with me back to the door you came in and join me, and we'll walk back down the steps. About 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We memorized the vision. We embraced it. We are capable of bringing our future now. All right. We're back down. That was great. Okay. Let's head over and sing another song. I've got a really fun one now.
Yeah.
For you to join in on. Cannonball?
Yeah.
Okay, join with us, you guys. Sing this fun song, okay? You know the lyrics are right here on Facebook for you.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
From the great Atlantic Ocean to the wide Pacific shore, from the green New Hampshire mountains to the Southland Cajun lore, well, she's mighty tall and handsome and loved by one and all. She's a combination, call a Wabash Cannonball. them all.
Listen to the jingle, rumble and roll. As it glides along, what lands through the hills and by the shore. Hear the mighty rush of our engines, hear the lonesome hobo's call. We're riding through the jungles on the Wabash Cannonball.
We are eastern states of Dennis, so the people always say. Chicago way to the hills of Minnesota, where the ripping waters fall. The changes can be taken on the Wabash Cannonball.
Tell how much fun we're having up here. So glad you're with us today. Hey, I'm going to take calls now on my little red phone. Promise you it's working. And see you there. I am sitting here outside in the softest breeze ever, just like this little tiny breeze, with all my best friends and this incredibly gifted band. I'm so lucky. I can't tell you what gratitude I have for you guys, my fellow band members, where I get to be with these pros. This is an amazing. You understand these people are extraordinarily talented. They're at the top of their game, and I get to horse around and learn from them. So I'm having a wonderful time. This is so much fun. And here we go, huh? Fingers crossed. Hi, this is Deborah.
Hello. Wait,
hello. Oh, good. I hear a person. Hi, what's your name?
My name is Kendra.
Hi, Kendra. Where are you in the world?
I live in Upper Manhattan.
Okay, great. How can I help you, Kendra?
Well, I've been dealing with Hashimoto's, an autoimmune disorder, for the past 10 years.
Right, yeah, I'm familiar with it. That's a long time to have it. Uh-huh.
Yeah. And I also struggle with regulating my mood and energy levels that manifest in borderline personality disorder-like symptoms.
Uh-huh. And you sound really young. Maybe under 40?
I am under 40, yes.
Uh-huh, okay. Let me just make an observation, because I'm sensing you right now very clearly. And the personality issues are really related to the medication that you need to take for the Hashimoto's.
Okay.
You're taking something, right?
The levothyroxine and NP thyroid.
Yeah, of course. And It can, you're very vata, that's the energy of the air, okay? And us air people, me too, we don't do very well on pharmaceuticals. We kind of overreact or we react incorrectly. So you need...
That makes a lot of sense.
I'm sorry?
That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, and you need the stuff. The stuff is helping you with the Hashimoto's, but it's skewing mm-hmm. your moods. So it's not you.
Mm.
I would venture a guess that you don't have any kind of a personality disorder at all. I'm not sensing it. I'm sensing a drug effect. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And I think if you know that, you'll probably feel a lot better about yourself and probably be able to rein in when you feel like depressed or anxious or uncomfortable or, you know, all these feelings. You want to be telling yourself, that's not me. That's the drug. That's not me. You know, for example, if you were suffering from postpartum, as some women do, you know, you would want to tell them, you know, that's not really you. That's the hormones that are coursing through you that are causing that. That's not you permanently.
Mm-hmm.
And it's much easier to handle ourselves and our emotions when we know that. I would encourage you to be thinking this little mood thing I have is not some disorder at all. It's just a side effect of what I'm taking.
Mm-hmm. Right. Which could that also include other things that I'm taking into my body, like supplements mm-hmm. and such?
Could. The only one I'm sensing is it's thyroxine, right?
Mm.
Is that what you're taking?
Yeah.
Yeah. That I can feel it.
Yeah, I mm-hmm. haven't been on it since for a little bit, just because it was such a low dose.
Yeah.
Yeah, and
it's
I
really
went
hard
into
on
hyperthyroid.
You. I'm sorry?
Yeah, I went super hyper recently, yeah. And I just couldn't handle it anymore, so I took myself off of it.
Yeah. Are you seeing a super-duper board-certified endocrinologist? Or are you seeing I bet you're seeing the other doctor, right?
I haven't in a while. When I lived in Idaho, I saw a functional medicine specialist that had done a lot of good for me. But, I was still, again, dependent on the medication. But at least we were trying to be more specific.
I'm not wild about the fact you pulled yourself off. Those things have to be really carefully withdrawn.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, otherwise it can send you into a little bit of a tailspin, and you feel a little bit depressed right now and kind of low, right? Kind of low.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
I would encourage you to make two different appointments, one with, or maybe in sequence, maybe not at the same time, but I'd love for you to see somebody really good in Western medicine in the endocrinology field. And maybe somebody more dialed into Hashimoto's. One or the other here real soon. And if you don't like them or their approach, see somebody else. Just see somebody else. But
okay.
I think you should have some help. It feels hard and unpleasant, right?
Which is why I'm seeking, you know, help mm-hmm. in many different ways, because the best approach I've had so far has been holistic approaches.
Uh-huh. Have you looked for someone like that?
Not in New York yet.
Mm-hmm.
But Idaho is a little bit more difficult. I might actually have an easier time finding someone.
You know, I'm being guided to tell you about homeopathy. Have you tried it?
Can you describe more?
Homeopathy is little tiny, thousands of times diluted little either drops or tablets. It's originally from...
Oh, okay.
It's originally from the 1800s, and it's a wonderful system for people like you and me who are super sensitive to drugs. So it's not a drug.
Right, yeah.
It's the memory. It's the energetic memory of something. You know, something like
right,
a plant.
Right, it makes a lot.
Yeah, it would be great for you. And
yeah.
If you,
I've taken supplements, but
supplements might be supplements may be too much for you, too heavy.
Right, agreed. Yeah. I had one that would take the full dropper, which is like the recommended amount. I have it. I quartered it, and then I was doing two drops.
Uh huh.
And even two drops
was too much. Yeah. You know what they recommend I have a homeopathist, and I'm like you are. I have the same intolerance to stuff. They have you just sniff one sniff out of the bottle to see how you're going to react. One sniff of something that's one millionth of a thing. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah.
That resonates.
Why don't you drop me a note in through, message me through Facebook. And
okay.
I'll give you the link to homeopathy, and I'll kind of help you find one. You don't have to, you know, you don't have to go in their office. They can help you.
Okay.
It's not like they have to take your pulse or anything. Wonderful. They can help you remotely.
Okay.
It might
cool.
Might be the ticket for you. I wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, with my sensitive system.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I remember I was in my 20s and somebody decided I needed thyroid. Big mistake. And I only took one pill, and I remember laying on the floor and just wanting to die. One pill. That was the end of that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Uh-huh. It affected my mood so drastically. So we're all different. You know?
Yeah. And the more you say that, the more like I'm going back into my memory and thinking, oh yeah, when I started the meds is when the mood issues.
Right.
Like, so I had a childhood stuff, but not the way this is.
No, I'm not getting any mood disorder in your case. Write yourself a note. I am perfectly healthy. I have perfectly healthy moods. Make that your new mantra. All right.
I like that.
Yeah. I'm glad you called. And drop me a note.
Right.
Okay.
I will. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
Very helpful.
Take care.
Mm-hmm. You too.
Hi, this is Deborah. How can I help you?
Hey there. This is Tammy. How are you?
Hi, Tammy. Where are you?
I am in South Carolina. I'm
I could have guessed. I hear the accent.
Y'all come back and see us now. Are you here?
Yeah. Well, Tammy, how can I help you?
Well, I have had a lot of health issues. I am a care person for all. My husband's almost died 9 times this past year. He's had leukemia. But I have got lymphedema in my legs. I've had incarcerated hernia in my stomach from September when I had to have surgery.
Mm-hmm.
I've had an ovary. I've had another hernia. Now I have diabetes, and then I had my thyroid killed back in a couple years ago. And it shot my weight up to 400 pounds, and I've never been 400 pounds.
Oh, God, Tammy, I'm so sorry. Yeah.
Yes.
What a drag, huh?
Sensible,
yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, and I flew to MUSC in Charleston twice in the last couple of months through Miracle Flight.
Do you
and
have
when I got there,
do you have some loved ones in your life, somebody that lives with you?
Yes, I do.
Good. Mm-hmm. So you're not lonely. Right?
No, we have cats, and I have a bird. I have a possum. I have a raccoon.
A possum.
I have the neighbor. I have the neighbor's cat. I mean, I have everything in the border. But I still get lonesome in my in me because I'm not. I'm tired of being, you know,
yeah.
my My leg looks like it's going to bust. It's as big as my butt.
Uh-huh.
I just had an ultrasound on Friday, a bilateral on both of them.
Oh, my.
And they said they didn't see a clot in there.
Here's the good news, Tammy. You're actually... You're actually making great strides spiritually with all of these tasks and challenges you've taken on in this lifetime. So I know that maybe doesn't sound very reassuring, but you're really doing a pretty good job staying in, making lemonade out of those lemons. Yeah, and yeah. I want you to know we're glad you're here today. We're all here with you. Okay, it's just like you're right here in my garden. I'm connecting.
Wow.
I'm connecting to your energy field. I can feel you very strongly. All right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, I can really feel your heart.
I am on Sensiboid. When I take Sensiboid, that's that level of thyroxin.
Yeah, I know
when
what
I
that is.
When I take it in the morning, it makes me
Let me just expand your energy field a little more because I'm real connected to it right now. You'll feel way happier.
Okay.
All right. You take care. I'm glad you called.
Okay. Are you hanging up?
I have to go. I wish I could stay longer, Tammy.
Yeah, but I was going to ask you a question about which way do I need to go with, I have a career. I'm an esthetician and a reflexologist, and I'm all about homeopathic stuff.
Good.
That you just told me.
Right.
The other lady.
You're wondering which way to go? Even if you can't get out of the house, you can help people homeopathically.
Yes, okay. And I do, believe me.
Right.
There's a little girl from New York she goes and gets cancer treatment.
Uh-huh.
I tell them, I say, give her some Lent chocolate. That'll help calm her down. That'll help
I'm going to lose you here, Tammy. I'm all out of time. Wish I could stay longer.
So, can you tell me what I need to do then?
Yeah, I think you should. I think you should think about helping people a little bit homeopathically. All right.
How about my legs? How about my legs? What do you say about my legs?
You know what? I'm not getting clarity on that one. Not.
Wouldn't my swollen up leg as big as my butt?
All right. You take care.
Thank you.
I think we're out of time, right, guys? We got a real fun song we're going to sing here. Got a very special moment going. We are gonna celebrate the 4th here a little bit early. We want you to join with us. We aren't gonna be here on the 4th, so we thought, why wait? It's a great moment, right? And sing along with us, okay?
Oh, beautiful for speed.
Not just us Americans, but around the world. Just join in this moment of unity where we're all one. We're all one. There is no division.
America.
Pablo. That was so beautiful. Woo-hoo. And everybody, and Brian, famous filmmaker, has joined us today. Meet Brian, and he's got the festive hat and the cake, and just a few of our film crew have come on because they want cake, all right? So we love having you guys, and hey, don't forget, I've got a retreat coming up September 1, 2, 3, and 4, right here in Ojai, just around the corner almost. Beautiful bucolic setting to die for. Very inexpensive lodging. You know, bring your swimming trunks. Big Olympic sized pool. The band will be there. Here's your chance. We'll be singing all cover songs. I know you guys know them. And we'll be teaching and napping and eating. The eating will be all outside. Super super safe. The whole event is outdoors. So we'd love to have you. Again, you just go to DeborahKing.com/retreat for all the details. I'm already starting to run out of room, so don't wait too long. Right here in Ojai, California. All right. Until I see you again, and we'll be back, I think it's July 19th. Am I right? Somebody tell me?
Yes, it is.
Okay, July 19th. Until I see you then, have a lot of fun outdoors, and you take care.
I'm sitting on top of the world. I'm rolling along, let's roll along. I'm quitting the blues of the world. I'm singing a song, yes, singing a song. Glory, hallelujah, I just phoned the parson.